Well, for many kids in this country, playing sport can be almost as important as going to school. That being the case, to suggest that sport is out of the financial reach of many Australian families is, well, damn near un-Australian. 6.30's Max Futcher has been looking at the high cost these days of keeping kids off the couch.
The Borman boys love their footy.
Really scoring tries and kicking goals.
Their dad loves that they love it, but the price of that love is going up year after year.
Every kid's got to have boots, socks, shorts to be able to play.
Time and money spent on petrol getting to games and training are just the start. By the time Pierce kicks off for the under-10s at the start of the season, the boots have cost at least $50, $12 for socks, $28 for shorts, a mouthguard anywhere from $10 to $70, and headgear up to $100. Junior Rugby League sign-on fees are anything from $70 to $150 a year, and the Bormans are lucky. There's three boys in the family, two currently playing league, and they do just one sport per season. Some families are forking out for AFL, cricket, soccer and netball, throw in a ballet class or music lesson, and you get the idea.
Oh, only two of them luckily are in sport at the moment, so we just couldn't afford all of them to be in sport. Yeah, it's too dear.
I don't think I'd want to know, because it would be thousands. But at the end of the year, I get to see my son either make it to a grand final or this one do her dance concert, so worth me working the extra.
The Bureau of Statistics found sporting subscriptions per household rose 88% between 1998 and 2004, and has kept growing ever since.
Many of them are just finding it's too expensive, and they're removing their children from organised sport.
A Royal Life Saving report has found 50,000 primary school kids graduate unable to swim 50 metres or float for 5 minutes.
Children from lower socioeconomic backgrounds, from rural and remote areas, from Indigenous backgrounds and from multicultural backgrounds are missing out completely.
And it's not like the clubs are making money. Public liability insurance alone has skyrocketed.
Clubs have got a variety of expenses. The big ones are insurance, games maintenance, costs for referees, to have referees out there.
At the past two elections, National Senator Ron Boswell floated the idea of tax breaks for parents' spending on kids' sport, and nothing's happened.
There's a big reason to get kids away from that television set, away from the computer, and get them out playing competitively, and that's great for the kids. And a lot of parents can't afford it.
In the long run, active kids are cheaper for the economy than obese children.
Activity's not the only part, it's the biggest part of junior sport, but the kids learn life skills, they learn to deal with authority, with referees, they learn to take directions from coaches.
The government is a lot of the time talking that there's too many obese children and more children should play sport and be outside and be more active, and I feel maybe if they gave us some incentive to get kids in sport and maybe a rebate on some of the fees would be a big help.
So you've bought the footy boots, paid the sign-on fee, even organised a watertight carpool with the other parents, and then, kids being kids, they decide they don't want to play footy anymore, they want to do something else.
Just hope it's something cheap.
Max Futcher, not good.